I'm Gene Simmons, and I wear more makeup and higher heels than your mommy does.
Buddy, you're a boy, make a big noise, playing in the street, gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace, kicking your can all over the place, singing,
we will, we will.
My job is to create little rock gods.
Last week, Gene Simmons chose 13-year-old Josh to be the lead singer of a new rock band.
People always say, come Josh, sit on our table, not because they want to take the mic of me, but because I am Josh Bell Emperor.
Why pick someone who hasn't got a really good voice?
Because if he's the lead singer, no one will take us seriously.
This week, Gene will pick two new band members, a drummer and a guitarist.
We're all trying to get into this band, and someone's not going to be in it.
Christ Hospital Boarding School in West Sussex has taken on an unusual new teacher, the wild man of rock, Gene Simmons. He's got just 5 weeks to turn a Year 9 music class into a band of renegade rockers whose first big gig will be to support Motorhead. After a week of Mr. Simmons' classes, his 13-year-old pupils are taking their rock and roll studies very seriously.
In what year did Elvis release his first single on Summer?
1954. Or six. Yeah, 54.
What is the name of Rolling Stones' enigmatic frontman?
Mick Jagger.
That's it.
Right.
Last week, Lord of the Rings fanatic Josh was given the first role in the band, and as frontman, he's already working on his stage presence.
Thunderbolts and lightning, very, very frightening. Galileo, 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 Figaro, make it go.
By himself again.
Very singing Queen.
Who cares? All the fun.
Doing? Before, I was Josh Bell, who was quite timid and spoke Elvish. Now, I'm Emperor. Rockstar.
Josh, he's really psyched up about this. He won't even answer to anything apart from Emperor, and rock singers are supposed to be arrogant, but I hope he doesn't get too arrogant.
This week, Gene is picking a drummer and a guitarist. But before they get their hands on any instruments, he wants the whole class to loosen up.
Who wants to scream?
One, two, three. Mr. Cool, you got to scream? Don't worry, Lucien, go.
Ah!
Ha ha, love that one.
Ah!
Okay, that's your scream.
Ah!
Oh yeah, I like that one. That's rocking.
When it comes to primal screams, I'm in there. I love primal screaming.
These kids are more likely to be found playing air violin in their dormitories, but Gene wants to see how they handle the imaginary axe.
Who's got rock running through their veins? Who's cool, who's not? Who's afraid? Who's self-conscious? Who belongs in a candy store? Who belongs on stage? Who knows how to rock? Playing guitar backwards, yeah. Get in the middle.
Get your motor running. Head out on the highway.
Yeah.
Looking for adventure.
I'm playing head guitar.
Comes away.
Go, yeah. Fifi, go. Oh, yeah. You rock.
Out in a loving embrace. By all of the guns and what's that?
to them. No, don't stop.
We can fly so high.
And then everybody sing it. Chorus, two, three.
Born to be wild.
Camilla has only been at the school for 6 weeks and she's struggling to let her hair down.
I think I probably am finding it a lot harder than the others are. I think that partly that's because they know each other and they have more confidence in what they think. Find it very hard to kind of get up and just do something if I don't see why I'm doing it or what the sense in it is. Find it hard to let myself go, but I don't want to either. I don't think it's right.
My intention is to get Camilla to snap out of it. I'm convinced I'm going to crack through that shell. Camilla is going to become someone she never thought she could ever become. I will make sure of that.
Most school field trips involve theatres and art galleries, but Jean's got other ideas.
Are you ready to rock?
He's taken his music class to London and their first ever gig to see rock band Placebo. Some of the class are starting to see rock and roll in a whole new light.
I'm into rock music now. I thought it was quite vulgar in the beginning.
Last night was all right. It was quite an exhilarating experience, actually.
But not everyone's so impressed.
Honestly, it was just noise to me.
I just had my earplugs in the whole way through.
I think that I'll always like classical music more than I like rock music. And now I've been to a rock concert and I've seen rock music, I still feel the same. I just feel that so much of it is pointless noise.
We don't need no education. We don't need no thought control.
Jean can't make all of his pupils feel rock music emotionally, but maybe he can win them over intellectually. The Debating Society is one of the school's proudest traditions, so they invited their newest member of staff to defend his right to teach rock and roll.
I'd like to take this chance to welcome everyone here to the Christ Hospital debate today. In particular,
there have been some strange debates over the years, but none quite so odd as a vulgar American rock star versus a veteran of British broadcasting, Nicholas Parsons.
This house believes that rock music has no place in our school. If there's no further ado, I'd like to bring this to session.
I have nothing against rock music. I'm even somewhat responsible for having promoted rock music, because I have, for a number of years, starred or played in that wonderful musical, The Rocky Horror Show. And I think it would be completely out of place if a master was to get up in front of the pupils at the school and suddenly say, "Let's do the time warp again." You would probably give him a round of applause like that. But has that got any place in the teaching of schools?
I believe rock and roll is modern folk music. It is the music that unites people. It's the music that makes everybody rock to the beat of the same drummer, if you will.
Rock music can lift you up, but it can set the passions alight. It can stimulate to the extent that all the lust within you rises up.
It's a huge industry. It thrives on new people, and you can make enormous sums of money.
The most important thing I must challenge is that you should worship the great god of money.
Yes.
No, that is fatal. Maybe in America, where they do worship money more than this.
I personally have made over $100 million. Don't you want to figure out how to make $100 million? You don't? If there's any dollar that you don't want, would you please give it to me? Finally, and most importantly, rock and roll rocks.
Jean was expecting a fight from 77-year-old Nicholas, but he wasn't banking on a moral reprimand from a bunch of teenagers.
But, you see, it's not all about riches. Money doesn't buy you everything. You inextricably link the two concepts of music and sex. Rock music is adopted by many as a lifestyle. And how can this sort of behaviour be appropriate in a school environment?
For those who think that rock music's not a bad influence, Gene Simmons claims to have slept with 4,600 women.
My character has been attacked, and I resent the point that I claim that I slept with 4,600. I object to that.
But there's at least one rock disciple who's quick to fight Gene's corner.
May I remind you that rock originally came out of hymns by the black slaves?
Okay. I'd like to remind the floor of the motion here today, which is this House believes that rock and roll has no place in the school. Those in favour of the motion, could you please raise your hand? Okay. And those who oppose the motion? This motion has been defeated.
Gene has convinced most of the children that rock and roll does have a place in school, but his love of wealth and women has failed to impress his pupils.
Personally, I don't really agree with his morals on money because, I don't know, I just think that you can have all the money in the world, but it's not gonna, if you don't have anyone to share it with, then it's not gonna make you happy.
The fact that Mr. Simmons says he slept with all these women, I don't really like that idea. It's just kind of wrong.
I don't believe that life, the whole point of life, is for money and achievements necessarily. But my life is for music and friends and love and I just don't agree.
I've been hearing all my life he's got far too much money and far too many girls. Translation, I wish I could be Gene Simmons. That's how it feels. And right now they're going, oi, he's a real asshole. You bet I am.
Gene Simmons has been at Christ Hospital for 10 days, but he hasn't exactly endeared himself to the staff and pupils. Now he's got an opportunity to redeem himself. The Demon of Rock has been invited to take hymn practice in the chapel.
Good morning, everybody.
And they won't find this song in their hymn books.
A few years ago, we wrote a song, this band that I'm in, called God Gave Rock and Roll to You. Maybe you can help me.
If you want to be a singer or play guitar, man, you got to sweat or you won't get far, because it's never too late to work nine to five. I used to. You can take a stand or you can compromise. You can work real hard or just fantasize. But you don't stop living till you realize. God gave rock and roll to you. Gave rock and roll to you. Gave rock and roll.
When Mr. Simmons at chapel, it was better than normal chapel because he did something a bit more fun.
He got people clapping, and he got a really good applause at the end.
Put it in the soul of everyone. You know what? Put it in the soul of everyone.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.
It was wonderful sitting, listening to the children singing God Gave Rock and Roll to You together. It was a really moving experience, and I think he was touched by it, and I think the children enjoyed it. So it was a good experience, and it showed that he respected our traditions.
The school isn't used to the attention of the national press, but news of Gene's new band has been leaked. And if they're going to be rock stars, the kids are going to have to do the odd photo call. But these are school children. They still have lessons to go to, and the deputy head won't stand for truancy.
I've got to go to lessons.
What about her? Just what? You.
No, we need to go to lessons.
OK, after you. Oh. Get it right in the front.
Though she's not entirely immune to the lure of the spotlight.
One, two, three. Excellent.
Come on, folks, let's go and do the day job.
But she's concerned that Gene may be turning little angels into monsters of rock.
It's interesting seeing you trying to undo the good work that we've done at school to teach the children how to behave. If they can go for the I'm an arrogant rock star who doesn't care, that's fine. As long as when they come back through that door, they can go back to being normal Christ Hospital children. I mean, the one who does worry me a little bit is Josh. I mean, my worry is that when the project's over,
yeah,
Josh will find it more difficult than the others to go back into real life, because he tends to throw himself wholeheartedly into whatever he's doing.
Well, I want us to have our own cool. I don't want to follow anyone else. I want to be individual. Because you've got to break the rules. You've got to jump off the... You've got to take yourself. Jump off the seat and go... Aah! That's what rock's about.
Josh may be a committed convert to rock and roll, but Camilla is determined to stick to the style and subtlety of classical music.
I still don't want to be a rock star. I still don't like rock music. I still think it's pointless noise. I like beautiful music. I like music with, like, wholeness and fullness and rich sound and... not just noise, which is what rock music is, but... yeah.
But her classical training won't help Camilla in her next lesson, because Jean wants her to hit something really hard.
I want total aggro rock star aggression. You're an animal. You're about to jump on that and kill it.
Camilla, get up there. Bash it around. Bash it any way you want. You don't have to look at it like it's fragile. I don't care if you break it or kick it over. Just do what you feel. Aggressive. Hit it hard. All over. Hit everything at once.
Yeah! Ow.
They may be accomplished classical musicians, but none of the kids are able to hold down the most basic rock beat. Until Dudley picks up the sticks.
I'd like to be a drummer in the band because, I mean, I know how to play the drums. I think I'm the only really real person in the band who actually plays full drum kit.
But Dudley is a mini musical maestro. He can play anything he picks up, including the guitar.
I play the organ, drums, cello, violin, most brass instruments, kind of everything, really.
We have a dilemma, and that's called the Dudley Dilemma. I'm looking for a guitar player, and I'm also looking for a drummer. The problem is that they both might be Dudley. Dudders has the rock and roll feel. Dudders has a rock and roll kick. He also plays guitar like he was on fire. I mean, he'll throw himself into it. He'll roll all over the floor.
Run up it like a rock star.
He's fearless, which has a lot to do with rock and roll. So whichever instrument he goes on is going to come off well. The other instrument is going to suffer slightly. I'm going to have to find someone who can get by doing it.
One person who should be able to get by on the drums is accomplished percussionist Richard.
I'm in the National Children's Orchestra, where I play percussion. My favourite things about percussion is whenever you're playing in a new sort of orchestra or playing in some band or group, is you're always sort of one of the main roles because everyone hears you.
Yeah!
I also want to play drums because I can't really play much else, like I can't play guitar. Don't really want to be the stylist or something, or makeup designer.
There's not much competition for Dudley on the axe. His main rival is Jesse, the only other person who's picked up a guitar before.
The only thing in the actual band I really want to be is guitar. Last resort, sort of bass, and if I don't get either, kind of screwed. Oops, sorry, I didn't answer that, am I?
Stop. That's really powerful.
Jesse and Dudley have been friends since their first day at school, so there's more at stake than just a place in the band.
I just feel as if I am going to be lead guitarist and Jessie's not. And that's going to kind of upset her. And I don't want to do that because she's my friend.
I would love to play the guitar. That's really like the main aim at the moment. But it's weird because I don't want it to sort of affect my friendship with Dudley. So yeah, I've got to see what happens.
When are we going to find out the people in the band?
Why do you want to know?
Because we've been sort of, what's that word? On the edge for like 2 days. It's a long time when you think about it a lot.
And you really want to know?
Yeah.
Oh, well.
The anticipation is quite a lot at the moment. If I wasn't in, I'd prefer to know now rather than having to wait like another week or whatever and then finding out I wasn't there, because then I would have been thinking about it the whole time and thinking about it as a possibility.
The good thing about being Jean Simmons, and even better about being Mr. Simmons, is that no one decides anything. I decide everything, because you see, I'm an arrogant rock star. That's what I do. That's my job.
The waiting is over. All the pupils have been assessed and Jean's decided on the next two band members.
We need a guitar player and a drummer. Dudders, come on up. So, you're pretty good, aren't you?
Yeah.
Good, pretty good, or great?
All right.
Drummer! You know, most of the time, guitar players are guys. But do we care? Bagpuss, come on up. You want to be a rock star?
Yes.
Are you willing to be the animal trainer, crack the whip, and take that guitar like it was a weapon?
Yes.
Well, then give me five, guitar player.
I don't know what I would have done if I hadn't got there.
I feel a bit disappointed because I'd really like to be sort of playing something.
I'm well chuffed because I got just exactly what I wanted. Now I'm just going to go out there, kick some bum, make some noise, and have a bit of fun.
How am I as a teacher? I'm stunningly good. I am brilliant. God, you're good. You're goddamn right.
Coming up next week, Shock Rock comes to Christ's Hospital. The Demon performs to a really tough audience.
Not quite my style, I'm sorry.
And Gene reveals the final lineup.
Time to announce the band.